like Minnesota. Cold like Minnesota. Cold like Minnesota.
Kuznick feeds it, shot, goal! Kuznick to Rocher, it's 6-4, Austin Maple Grove!
Cold like Minnesota. Cold like Minnesota.
Need to stay up out the streets if you can't take the heat. You need to stay up out the streets if you can't take the heat. Cause it get cold like Minnesota.
Welcome to 10 Minutes. I'm Tony Scott.
10 Minutes with Tony Scott.
That's not the name of the show.
Why not? It can be the name
of
the
Tony
show.
It's Tony Scott. It should be actually, 10 Minutes with Tony Scott and Peter Rodney.
Actually, today it's going to be, it's not even a rundown. It's a sprint down. We're going to try to cram everything
double.
Into one show.
Boys, girls, everything. You name it.
Yeah.
But a little bit of a.
Like and subscribe.
But a little bit of emphasis on the Squirtacular.
Yeah. Which sponsor do you want to go? Do you want to go left or the right?
Map South Hockey, Mendota Heights, Minnesota.
Yep. If I had a child, I would send them to Map South. They've got it all. They've got a dry land area on site. They have a weight room right next to the dry land area. They have ice. They
it's
got
basically
everything.
Hockey Disneyland.
No.
Yeah, it is.
It might be more expensive, but sure, Hockey Disneyland.
Disneyland is more expensive than...
That's what I meant to say. Yes, I meant to say Disneyland is like, the more expensive
version.
That's
a real good
version.
Promo for the show.
I meant to say that Disneyland is far more expensive, but best bang for your buck, Map South Hockey.
Great stuff. Great stuff. Check them out, Map South Hockey. All right, let's talk some puck. We're going to start with the 10As. We're going to skip over the Squirts because we're going to come back to them at the end.
Yep.
10As, Woodbury. I call this team like the greatest 10A hockey team of all time.
That's a
they
little
They played
much.
Like 6 or 8 games in November little and then much. Didn't record a game until mid-January, and they just keep beating people and beating people and beating people. Yeah. They won, I think they won the Cake Eater, and I know they won the St. Luke's. This is a juggernaut. I think they played – last year they played in Eden Prairie. I'm hoping to see them at the Eden Prairie tournament at the end of the season. That's a good squad.
Gotcha.
12A, who won the St. Luke's tournament?
12A? Invitational?
Invitational.
There you go. Well, Edina shouldn't feel too bad. They lose at 10As. They win at 12As 4-1 over Austin Maple Grove. The Hornets, now number 2 in the state, according to the YHH staff rankings.
Finished third at Danglefest after a loss to number 1. Why is that? A very close game. And
3-2.
Over on rink 3. I like this team a lot. I think, you know, I hate to say it, Not a shocker here, but I think this team could win state.
Wow, a 12A Edina team winning state tournament.
You
if
just
there
wrote
was a box.
Script. How is your script anyway for 12A? We did all these teams.
Which ones?
You just did all the 12s. So you did.
No, I didn't.
Wayzata,
I did
Edina. You did Andover. Which one of those did you like the best out of those scripts?
Out of the scripts?
Yeah.
Ooh, that one was tough. Bemidji's.
Bemidji's was good.
Bemidji's. The northern teams are always easier.
Yeah, that was a good one. That was a good one. All right, 15A, a little bit of an upset. Yep. Tonka made up a lot of those 12As last year. Katya Sander and all those girls who won the Danglefest last year. They're playing 15As this year. They beat Edina 2-0 in the St. Luke's, and they are now number 1. Congratulations to Tonka.
Is that really a surprise, though?
No. Not really.
Okay.
Not really. I mean, because both teams probably lose a kid or two to private schools.
Yeah.
You know, playing eighth grade.
Or a
hockey.
Kid or three to their high school program.
Yeah. Or to the actual. We did. They lost one. Lorelai Nelson, we saw her last night over. She'd be playing 15As, but she's up for varsity and played quite well. Had the assist on the game winning goal.
Oh.
All right. Let's switch gears to boys. Pee Wee A, West St. Paul beats. STMA, they win the Proctor tournament at a
somehow.
Really nice rink in Proctor, by the way.
Yeah, good for West St. Paul.
I drove by the Proctor rink.
For fun?
On my way to the Hermantown game on Saturday.
Gosh.
So there you go.
Oh, Lord.
Pee Wee B's, Edina White, who won our Gobbler tournament.
Yep.
They win the Roseau tournament. Who'd they beat?
They beat Forest Lake. A burgeoning rivalry between... is burgeoning the right word?
Yeah, that's the
a
right word.
A burgeoning rivalry between the Hornets and the Rangers.
They were in the semifinals of the Danglefest last year over at Richfield. You broadcasted that game.
I did.
All right. Bantam A, maybe the best team in the state. Maybe the best team in the state.
I mean, maybe.
East Grand Forks might be the best Bantam team in the state. They beat Moorhead.
Mm-hmm.
They went 4-1 and won the Star North in Grand Rapids.
They did.
They beat Fargo's Double A team 5-2. That's a nice team that they beat.
It's a pretty good
squad. So hats off to Eastside Hockey. They got a nice squad.
I think that high school team could use a couple
of them right now. Will East Grand Forks repeat at Bantamay? And I'm going to give you you say yes, and I'll tell you why no.
So I don't have a choice here?
No, you just I think the reason they might lose.
Yes, East Grand Forks will repeat as Bantamay state champions.
There's a district.
And here's why.
District 3. Well, we just made their case, right? District 3 is loaded. Orono's good. Osseo Maple Grove is good. Armstrong Cooper is good. Delano, who we saw in our finals of the Lumberjack Cup, is
Roseville.
Good. Roseville's in District 2.
Oh.
But District 3 has got three or four really good teams. Who comes out of there might be battle-tested. I think a lot of these Metro teams might be battle-tested by the time they get to East Grand Forks for the state championship. That's
really
where they play.
Oh.
Do you think hosting is good for them or bad for them? And they're going to be packed houses when they play. Or is it too much pressure for a 14-year-old to play in front of all those people?
Bad for them.
I think it is, too.
I was in Moorhead
too
when
many distractions.
Went
yeah.
to state. And, yeah, it was a packed house, and then Moorhead lost.
Right. Wayzata, maybe?
It was Wayzata.
Yeah.
That was a...
Why
that
I
was an
that.
Interesting game.
Why I know that.
Because that was the game where Wayzata mother stomped over to the benches and started
and said
telling,
it wasn't fair.
Well,
right?
She was telling the kids standing along the glass that they couldn't
stand there
and yell at the Wayzata goalie.
That. I remember that.
You're fighting a losing battle there.
All right. Last but not least for the boys, Prior Lake wins their home tournament.
Yeah.
Usually sometimes you get a light turnout for your home tournament. They beat Osseo Maple Grove, who won our Gobbler twice.
OMG Black.
Number one team in the state, Prior Lake, proving it.
Yeah, congratulations to Prior Lake.
I agree. All right, now let's talk some score tack. You want to hold this?
No.
All right. That's not the Squirtacular trophy.
Normally, I don't.
The Eagles are different colors.
Normally. I give out one game puck.
Silver, that's gold.
It's great. Oh maybe gosh. It just got faded by the sun. So I got this baby back this week. Brett Witzke, who won the original state Squirt B championship, which we came up with on a whim by a few parents from Moorhead and Edina and Maple Grove, said, hey, you should put together a tournament. We did. It was successful. So successful, we put together another tournament for A's and B's the following year called the YHH Squirtacular.
Oh,
and if it weren't
man.
For this trophy right here, we wouldn't be playing this big tournament starting next week. The 10th annual YHH Squirtacular.
Is this really the 10th one?
Yes, it is. 2013, Bobby Brink, Grant Slukinski, Justin Janicki, Brock Faber. I mean, the list of D1 and professional players in that tournament was long, let me tell you.
But if you have 100 teams, I mean.
There was only 32 teams. That which makes it even more impressive.
Can we go back to that?
It's 32 teams. Yeah, life would be good, wouldn't it? Okay, let's talk. We went down memory lane a bit with the trophy.
Do you want to put that down?
Yeah, I'll put it down. I'll put it down.
Before you hurt yourself?
I won't hurt myself.
Old man.
What's your favorite memory or a memory that, you know, that sticks out to you for the Squirtacular?
Last year, I was working door security because that was back in the dark ages.
The two per?
When we had to keep
two people per
player and do head counts and all that gobbledygook. But a young man came in. He was wearing a Woodbury toque. And he said, can I bring this to the Woodbury locker room? And I said, well, you have to tell me what it is. Is and you got to come right back out. And he's like, oh, it's a gold medal. And I thought, yeah, of course it's a gold medal.
Sure,
like a
it
box
is.
Of Fruit Loops.
Sure.
It turns out it was a gold medal. It was Neil Broughton's gold medal, and that was pretty cool. I'd never seen one of those in real life, so
that was very neat. I actually held the same gold medal, not Neil's, but Dave Christian's gold medal a few years prior to that.
Did you bite it to see if it was actually gold?
No, I did not bite it. I was just happy to touch it. And his grandson, Henry Meyer, was on the team, and they did win the championship. So hats off to Woodbury. See if they can repeat. I have a repeat.
It's going
to
be tough.
Up here
it's going to be tough.
I don't have the exact year. I want to say it was 2016, the first year we moved out of Bloomington up to the Super Rink. And we're hosting, it was a quarterfinal game, I believe, between Stillwater and Rosemount. William Whitelaw. I just remember Thomas Anderson was the goaltender for Stillwater.
Thomas No H.
And he, yeah, Thomas No H. He was the goaltender for that team, and they beat Rosemount in a shootout. And the place was just, it was one of those, you know, where everybody from the rink ends up in the in the rink to watch.
And the game had gone long, so you have players and parents waiting for the next game.
Yeah, it was a special game, and Stillwater wins. We still got a picture of Bobby Dustin to this day with his arms up when the puck went in. It was a pretty special day. That day was pretty cool.
I remember that game.
Intense.
I remember shooting that game standing in the stands.
Yes, you might have got the picture of Bobby Dustin.
Probably.
I was restoring order in the stands. It was crazy.
I was probably following around personal hero Bobby Dustin.
Well, we will build more memories this year. We're back to pin
trading. Some good,
trading.
Some bad.
Yes, mostly good. We will have pin trading again, which I anticipate seeing over 1,000 kids in the upstairs lobby trading pins, plastic bags.
Please do
everywhere.
Not just drop down to your knees in front of walkways. You're going to get stepped on.
Yeah, you could get stepped on. But, you know, we love the energy. Are you ready to make some picks?
I'm ready to make some picks.
Four divisions.
I actually
right?
looked at the rosters for all of these teams, so I feel fairly confident.
Four divisions. Selections. There's a platinum, a gold, a silver, and a bronze. Platinum is the double A, we call it. The top 24 teams in Minnesota and those invited to the tournament.
Yep.
I'm going to take a repeat here.
Okay.
I'm going to take Woodbury. I saw them play Minnetonka a few weeks back. It's a really good team. It's one of those two first line type teams. Good goaltender. You name it. I'll go Woodbury. Who are you going with?
I'm going to go with Stillwater.
Stillwater.
I'm going to go with Stillwater. A lot of looking at the roster, a lot of familiar names from some of our.
I bet there's a Bjornley on there.
There is a Bjornley on there.
Is there a Rankin?
Is a Rankin out there. I swear they have a Rankin and a Bjornley farm
somewhere
in the Stillwater area. Yeah. But looking at that roster, a lot of familiar names from our offseason stuff. Good coaching behind the bench. I think Thomas Vanek is listed as the head coach.
Oh, no way. So he's got twins on the team.
There are two Vaneks on
there. They're twins, yeah.
So, you know, if you can get drafted in the first round, you can probably win.
It's his birthday today, actually.
Thanks for stepping all over the compliment that I was just
trying to give. All right, go ahead.
If you can get drafted in the first round, you can probably win the Squirtacular.
Let's see if you can do it, Thomas.
Yeah, we'll see. I don't know. It probably has nothing to do with the other.
Okay, I was going to say, a friend of mine saw the Stillwater team play. And he said, that's the best squirt team I've ever seen. And he's got three elite sons that have played quite a bit of hockey.
Well,
so
good for me.
You made a good pick. Yes. I think I got a good pick. I think Minnetonka is a good team. I've talked to them about this show. I think Moorhead will have something to say about this before it's all said and done. So here we are at the gold division.
Yep.
What do you got?
Burnsville Apple Valley.
That's a good pick.
Thank you.
I'm going to go a little bit off the board here. I'm going to pick Duluth. This is Duluth's first ever appearance in the Squirtacular. I cannot wait to see the Duluth pin.
All right. Silver Division. I'm going off the board and out of the state.
Yeah.
And I'm going to take the Arizona Junior Coyotes. And I've made this point before. You never know what you're going to get with an out-of-state team. They could show up and they could struggle, or they could show up with a bunch of studs and roll through the bracket.
You never know.
Arizona usually brings a few good players, and we'll see if they can put it all together.
They won it. They won this exact division 5 years ago. It was their 2007s playing
that's
at Minor, and they won the B division, and I think they got a good shot. That's a good choice. All right, last but not least, let's go bronze. This is like the Squirt B2 division.
Yep.
I'm going to go Edina Black. They're 10-0 in District 6. That's a tough district for any level of squirt hockey.
Mm-hmm.
I'll pick the Blacks.
And I'm going to take Elk River.
Okay. All right, good pick.
Because
tough.
Because I said so.
Right? All right, let's move on to the Boom Roasted and the Game Pucks. Start off your Boom Roasted.
Yeah.
And I'll grab the puck that Todd normally throws to us.
My Boom Roasted is more of a preemptive, don't be a jerk ball.
it's a big weekend. There's a lot of emotion,
a lot going on. There is a lot of emotion. But yes, there is a gate fee. It is, I believe, $10
for the weekend, $5
for the day.
Yeah.
And you would not believe how far some people who drive $80,000 SUVs will go to avoid paying $10 to get in for four games. There is a gate fee. Just bear that in mind.
Yep.
And in the lower level, if you've been to the super rink, there's a stairway up. There's a hallway down the side. Please go upstairs.
Please go upstairs.
If I see one more person get stepped on by a skate or rolled over by a bag because they're standing where they don't need to be, outside the locker rooms.
Yeah, don't be outside the locker rooms. You do not need to be
in that area.
Let the players play. Let the coaches coach. Let the fans cheer. Cheering is upstairs.
Otherwise, we're just going to take off everybody's skate guards and let them walk around with blades.
It's a magical event. I'm excited for it.
Yes.
I have one that has nothing to do with the Squirtacular.
This is one of my favorites. It's
an annual thing. If your team is playing games that, especially at the squirt level, squirt particular, don't put in scores where there was no refs and no score sheet. Don't put in fake scores like 6,900 to nothing. Mm. We'd actually know who you are, and if you are a repeat offender, we will report you, and we will report you to not just the police, but we will report you to your coach and to your association.
That's so worse.
We know who you are. Please stop putting fake scores in. It just slows us down. And we want to provide great content. We want to provide great events. Just is a
it also makes speed you look bump like that a we jerk don't
want.
Ball.
We don't want the speed bump. So please stop putting in fake scores. Let's do it.
All right. Game pucks.
You want to go first?
My game puck goes to Danny Bergen, the Chisago left forward. Is the new all-time scoring leader for the Wildcats. She has 247
points. She took it away from her friend, Jenna Lowry. I don't think that's
she broke Jenna Lowry's record. She now has 247 career points, and they still have six regular season games left, plus a section playoff game. So solid chance that she makes that unreachable.
It will be. All right, last but not least, game puck. This is an odd one. It has nothing to do with hockey, but has a lot to do with hockey. Okay. Jenny Slukinski, her and her husband, Tim Slukinski in Warroad, own a company called Lamplighter Hockey. We've done some advertising with them in the past.
Mm-hmm.
They make some good hockey products. Their son, Hampton, who played in the Hermantown versus World game, came to the rescue. Let us, Will Peterson and I, broadcast on her Facebook page because there was some technical difficulties with the other broadcast.
Yeah.
She held the camera like this, Peter, perfectly.
I hate still doing that even during shootouts.
She did it for an entire three periods, and we let us broadcast our network. Umpteen 600, 700, 800 people got a chance to watch the game and hear Will pull off a good broadcast. They might have heard me say a couple words of color or two. It was good. We had a fun time. It was a great game. Hermantown won the game. Beautiful game in overtime. It was fun hockey. Game puck goes out to Jenny for what she did for us.
And now we can pay for her Tommy John surgery after holding the camera.
Making fun of we would do a post-period wrap-up. I'm like, okay, well, let's give Jenny's arms a break because it was her arms that were amazing.
For three periods.
Well, we're gonna be doing a lot of lifting ourselves, young man, over the next 4 days. I'm excited to see it. 9 and 10 year old boys, a couple girls, I'm sure, mixed in there as well.
Yep.
Some siblings, parents. Let's do this. Let's get it on, Squirtacular style. For Peter Odney, I'm Tony Scott. We'll see you in Blaine.
Call like Minnesota. Call like Minnesota. Call like Minnesota. Call like Minnesota. Need to stay up out in the streets.